let me pick it up for you. It's a poem, girls. Listen to this. There was a beautiful girl called Joyce. What a smile, what a body, what a voice. She said, listen, Merv, you cute little perv, so I suppose I don't got any choice.
Get out, Patterson. Outside. And I have just been called to the governor's office because of you.
But I didn't write it.
I'm not talking about the note, and you know it. It's about time you started to grow up.
Oh, but I was
because just... Because if you don't, you're going to find yourself in very serious trouble. You've been getting away with all manner of things lately.
But I was just...
And don't for a moment think that I don't know who stole my purse. I didn't report you because I thought you were going to settle down and get an early parole. Apparently, I was wrong. But let me make this quite clear. Private lives of any member of the staff is no concern of yours. And unless you learn that lesson very quickly, you're going to find yourself in very serious trouble. Do you understand?
You look like you need something to calm your nerves a little.
This place is the bloody pits.
I agree. Come to my cell. I might have something to cheer you up.
I told you it was a mistake to let her in here with that bag of crisps.
We gave all the other girls a ride. We couldn't leave her out, could we? Anyway, she's the last.
We've been round this block 15 times. No wonder I'm dizzy.
I can't afford to make enemies at my time of life.
Oh, fair enough. But look at the mess she's made. Crumbs all over the joint. Good job we don't have to sleep in it. And look, she spilt champagne all over that lovely beige upholstery.
Well, I'll pay for any damage. Struth, you do carry on. I'll be glad to get back into the slammer.
Oh, don't, Etty. Why don't you stay? You drive me mad. But I hate the idea of you being locked up in prison. Call that robbery off before it's too late.
Look, you've been very good to me, Sadie, and I don't know what I'd manage without you, but I don't belong here. I belong inside.
You'd get used to it after a year or two.
Who's to say I've got a year or two? You see, you know Betty and Margot and whatever that fat one's name is. I can never remember her name. And I know my mob. They're a pretty rough lot, I know, but I know them and they know me. I know the rules. I mean, how would you like it if someone told you you couldn't ever see Betty again? I mean, look at the two of us sitting here. We'll get picked up for loitering in a minute. We must have missed three races already. All right, Victor, to the races and don't spare the Gigi's.
Well, it's not my fault they won't give you another dorm, so stop grizzling.
And I suppose it's not your fault they sent you in here to annoy me. You've come here to gloat, May Collins, and don't you try to deny me.
May, come over and make sure this gravy doesn't boil over. And what are you doing?
I'm just getting Mrs. Reynolds' afternoon tea tray ready.
Look, they'll be in here for lunch in 3 seconds. We're not even ready. Just do that later.
Oh, how clumsy of me. Oh, they're ruined. Nothing but crumbs.
Willie!
I suppose I'll just have to throw this packet away and open a fresh one.
All right, but do it after lunch.
Why, you sneaky old tart. What else have you managed to find today?
Well, it's funny you should say that. There are a few things Mr. Pringle asked me to put in the rubbish, but fortunately, I have an eye for recyclable objet d'art. All good, useful merchandise, wouldn't you say?
I've already given some out, but as soon as lunch is through, I want the rest distributed to the other blocks. Well, this won't last long.
That's right, so they'll be ready for some more when I hand it out later on, won't they?
Fair enough.
Just make sure they have it outside or after lock-up.
Seems a pity to waste it, just giving it away.
I don't see you offering to pay for it.
Yeah, but I'm a special case. I work for you.
You're very short-sighted, Lou, my dear. The whole point of this exercise is that it is free at the moment. But we want them begging for more.
When what they are, we'll hand out the strong stuff like cocaine, pills, heroin. Yeah, right.
Of course,
The smack must only go to the young girls, the ones who need regular work to support their expensive habit after they're released.
And then they go in the game, right?
Well, it wouldn't be fair to let them be released without a job now, would it? They'd only get into all sorts of trouble.
What's that for?
Stop this smell going through the air system.
Wouldn't want to get in a whiff of it in their gov's office or the staff room, eh?
Break it down, Julie. Run this hose down on it.
I can't help it.
Shh!
I just had this mental picture of the screws standing on the table in the staff room. It's not in the fumes.
Now I can just see it. Oh, four eyes. Oh, that's it. We'll make a smoker out of you, yeah.
I'd be too worried about the effects to do it a lot.
Oh, come off it. Nothing wrong with a bit of grass does less harm than booze.
Now, they're not really sure about that yet. Some scientists think that THC remains in the brain cells for 72 hours, whereas alcohol's cleaned out in a day.
Ball dust! I got off my face on ouzo once and felt like death for a week.
Now, that would have been due to inflammation of the cells. Your liver would have cleaned out the actual alcohol in 24 hours.
Oh, could have fooled me. Anyway, never been crook on dope.
Mixing it with tobacco is probably more harmful than the grass itself, you know.
Yeah?
Even a very small amount of nicotine can have a deleterious effect on the brain and nervous system. It's a psychoactive drug. It reacts on the body's neurotransmitters.
Neuro-what?
Neurotransmitters are the chemicals that carry nerve impulses by diffusing across the gap between nerve cells.
You've been a medical student or something?
No, nothing like that. I've probably read it in the paper or heard on the news or something. Oh.
Geez, you all right, Chuck?
I'd offer you some, but this is the last piece.
Oh, no worries. I don't reckon it'd go down too well with the swill they gave us for lunch, anyhow. Oh, but he's going.
Good. We don't want the natives to know we're working together, do we? I presume my little packages of heaven are on the way to the needy in the other blocks?
Yeah, sure. And everyone knows not to light them up until they're outside.
Something bothering you?
No, it's just Desmond. If she can mess it up, she will.
You don't think she can stop me, do you?
Not a chance. Desmond's history and she knows it. Now I've got Kath and Alice on side. Well, we can take care of her.
Quite. You worry too much. I've also organised some extra help from, well, let's just say official circles.
You mean a screw?
Never mind. This will take care of Myra for a start.
What are you going to do? Sweeten her up?
Acid. All I have to do is slip one of these and she'll be climbing the walls.
I've got to hand it to you. You're a smart lady.
You are off your face, aren't you?
Oh, it's cool, Mark.
Cool be buggered. It's one of the screws didn't get onto you. You smell like the drug squad in...